Hey guys, Mo Long here, and I am excited because I'm going to take a look at Waka running on the Asus Tinkerboard. Waka is a Linux-based distro which has RetroArch baked in, and RetroArch serves as the underpinnings for a lot of different retro gaming platforms such as RetroPie, Recalbox, and Batocera. But there's a lot less overhead with Waka because, unlike a lot of those other distros, Waka does not include any sort of front end such as emulation station. And what's really cool about Waka is it comes ready to use out of the box, so you don't need to fiddle with installing any BIOS. You don't need to configure your controller. You just fire it up and you're ready to load up your ROMs and start playing. You can run Waka on a number of different single board computers, like the Raspberry Pi and the Odroid XU4, but I really like using it on the Tinkerboard because it's a pretty powerful little single board computer that has an RK3328 Rockchip CPU with an ARM-based Mali T764 GPU. So the first thing that you're going to need to do is go over to the Waka website, go to Get Waka, and you're going to need to choose your host PC. So I'm using Windows, so I'm going to select Windows. Then what you're going to have to do, scroll down here and find Asus Tinkerboard. So then go ahead and download the image. Give that a minute to download, and then we're going to have to mount that to a micro SD card. I've now got that Waka image downloaded and it is compressed. So here it's an image.gz file. So I can mount that straight to a micro SD card using Etcher. But if you don't have that capability, then what you're going to need to do is decompress that with something like 7-Zip. I'm just going to fire up Etcher. Now I'm going to select my image. Select your boot medium. So in this case, I'm using a 32 gig micro SD card. If you're using the Tinkerboard S, you can also use eMMC. And once you're all set up to mount your Waka image to your boot medium, go ahead and hit flash. It'll take a couple minutes, but when you're finished, go ahead and pop that micro SD card or eMMC module into your Tinkerboard and power it on. All right, here we are in Waka on the Tinkerboard. And as you can see, it's the exact same user interface as RetroArch. Or if you've used the PlayStation 3, it looks very similar to the XMB there. So I think the best step to start with is going ahead and getting connected to the internet. So I'm going to use Wi-Fi. So you're just going to go over to Settings, Wi-Fi, and select your network. Now, just go ahead and enter your password. I'm using a wireless Xbox 360 controller, and it was recognized out of the box. I didn't have to map any of my buttons. And one of the other really cool features about Laka that really sets it apart from a lot of other retro gaming distros is that you don't have to go through and download specific emulator cores. Instead, they come pre-installed. Same with BIOS. So instead of going through and downloading the emulators that you want to use, what you can do is you can simply go here to load core and load the appropriate core for the games you want to play, whether that is Atari 2600, Atari 5200, maybe Nintendo. There are a ton of different options on here, including you do have a version of Doom that you can download. There's DOSBox, you're playing a bunch of DOS games. There are just a ton of different options that you can use. So to actually start gaming, there are a few different methods to go about that. You can go here to load core, fire up a core, and then load your content over here under load content. And then going to the appropriate directory. Or what you can do is you can go through and scan various directories. Since I'm running all of my ROMs off of a 256 gigabyte flash drive that actually has my RetroPie mount folder on it for use with RetroPie, what I'm going to do is go over here to scan directory. I'm going to select my flash drive, which is right here, and then I'm going to go find my ROMs folders. So there are a ton of different ways that you can organize your ROMs. You can throw them all into one folder, but I typically use a structure where there's a main ROMs folder and then subfolders for each system. So I'm just going to go here under ROMs, go under Atari 2600, then you're going to want to select scan this directory. And give that a minute. Depending on how many games you're actually importing and the size of those files, this could take a varying amount of time. So we're going to back out of there. Going to go over here. And as you can see, we've got our Atari games loaded up. And what's really cool is you can actually have box art download for the different games that you import. So the way to do that is go over here under your main menu, go under Online Updater, and toggle On-Demand Thumbnail Downloads to On. Go ahead and import a few more games. I've now got most of my ROMs loaded up. So we can scroll through those. We've got Atari 2600, Atari 5200, Atari 7800, Atari Jaguar, WonderSwan Color, WonderSwan, ColecoVision, got some Held Hand electronic game system stuff, PC Engine, Super Graphics, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Game Boy, N64, NES, Super Nintendo, Virtual Boy, 32X, Sega Game Gear, Sega Master System, Sega Mega Drive, the SG-1000, Neo Geo Pocket Color, Neo Geo Pocket, and PSP. So it's really easy to go ahead and load your ROMs up. And one thing I really like about Laka is just the fact that you don't have to worry about dropping ROMs in specific folders. You can pretty much have those in whatever folders you want to. And I do really appreciate how BoxArt does download for a lot of games. So it does have a really pretty interface. I want to go ahead and take a look at performance on a few different systems to see how the Tinkerboard handles emulation. So let's go ahead and look at some N64 emulation. I was pretty pleased with N64 emulation on the ASUS Tinkerboard, and GoldenEye ran actually pretty well on there. certainly better than on the Raspberry Pi 3 or Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. And I think it probably runs a little bit better on my Raspberry Pi 4. But that was certainly playable on the Tinkerboard. Granted, games that you play are going to be a little hit or miss. So now I want to take a look at some PSP emulation.
Suffering for years, Kratos, the once great general, now known as the Ghost of Sparta, had pledged himself as a champion to the gods of Olympus. In return, he hoped only to rid himself of the nightmares that haunted him for far too long. But for now, his only respite, his only relief from the sins of his past, was found in the heat of battle. And on this day, Kratos had been called upon by the gods to confront an unthinkable evil, unleashed on the city of Attica by the invading Persian army.
PSP emulation is really hit or miss, so God of War Chains of Olympus did not run well. It's not going to run well on the majority of single board computers out there. It runs quite a bit better on the Raspberry Pi 4, but for true PSP emulation, you're really going to need something such as the NVIDIA Shield TV or even a laptop or desktop to truly emulate that. I also want to try out a little bit of Dreamcast emulation.
Hey, hey, come on! It's party time! Let's have some fun! Alright, let's go make some crazy money! Go ahead and pick a car and driver. Baby Joe.
Yeah, we gonna have some fun.
Hey, 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 it's time to make some crazy money. Are you ready? Here we go.
Yeah.
Yo, hurry up over here.
Get your stuff, Wilson. Take the
to the cable car. Oh,
party time!
Hey!
Let
the job, let's go!
Well, come on, G.
Let's get going. You. Oh, ha! Pay more attention, though. Go that way, babe.
Well, come on, B. Let's get going.
Oh, I'm gonna be more careful. Move it, baby.
Yo, yo, stay in your seat.
Oh, crap. Hey, pay more attention, babe.
Today, you're going the wrong way. Follow the arrow.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yo, just chill out, man.
Move it, baby. Oh, much time.
Whoa. Get some quick, I'ma have to quit.
You better pick someone up. We're gonna run out of time. Time's up.
The Tinkerboard runs Dreamcast games really well. And since it runs Dreamcast and N64 pretty well, you're going to find really solid performance with emulating pretty much any older system. Atari 2600, 5200, 7800, Jaguar, WonderSwan, all of these are going to run really well, including Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Game Boy NES, and Super Nintendo. All those are going to just run flawlessly. You're not going to have any issues running Yoshi's Island, but still, I want to check it out. not surprisingly, SNES games run incredibly well. And then I also want to take a look at some Turtles in Time. There you have it. This has been Waka running on the ASUS Tinkerboard, and it's definitely one of my favorite operating systems for retro gaming. I do kind of wish that built in there were some kind of home theater PC capabilities like the Kodi Media Center built in, but ultimately it's not that difficult just to swap out micro SD cards. And I just think it's one of the easier retro gaming platforms to get started with, because you don't have to bother with scraping your ROMs. You don't need to even map your controllers. Everything just kind of works out of the box. So it balances being user friendly with also being super customizable for power users like myself. So there are a ton of different settings that you can tweak. And my only minor complaint is that sometimes game files don't import into playlists, so then you have to just load the content. For example, I have a number of PlayStation 1 games that are in a PvP format, and those I was unable to import into a playlist. So you can make a manual playlist and go ahead and import that, but it would be really nice if you were able just to kind of import it. But you can see under settings, there are a lot of different options that you have for setting your aspect ratio, vertical V-sync, stuff like that. You can select audio options, mess with your input device, change the user interface up. You can toggle on achievements. And there's even an AI service over here. So you just have a lot of different functionality built into Laka, and it's a super lightweight distro. So it's definitely one of my favorites, and I'm going to keep it around on a micro SD card. I actually have micro SD cards of Laka for a lot of my other single board computers. And if you haven't tried it out, I highly recommend you do so. Thanks for watching. Keep on gaming.